money. Gotta get the money. Money. Gotta get the money. Money bags.
Yo, what's going on, Elementz? It's your boy, Rise Tice, or Tice SODMG. And today, we're going to be playing some NBA 2K14 with my nephew, J-Man. Yes, he's from North Carolina, ladies, and he's single.
Take me back. Are you single? I'll be more
but our fam is here, and we're going to be playing some NBA 2K14. So without further ado, let's get right into it. Yeah. Game time.
This is L.
Now, I suck at NBA 2K, so don't get it twisted. He's really good. My challenge today is to at least get 20 points. My challenge. That's life for me.
That's life. You don't know Victor Oladipo.
Change, man. Change. Change.
Hey,
there used to be a guy. Our starting lineup. So look. Oh, I know Nelson. Francis. Francis was his name.
Tobias Harris. Francis. And it's Davis at the four slot. And look at the Bulls.
I don't even know. See, I didn't even know what the jump button was, yo. Yo, why you pressing start already?
I gotta change the camera angle.
What? What about how I feel?
I don't care.
Oh, wow. Down low, the two-time NCAA champion at Florida. The 6'11 tornado of energy and effort. It's the big man.
Yo, what?
You press the button. That's personal foul.
And it's Boozer.
I'm trying to personally take the ball from you. That's
tell you what,
that's
it's hard to argue
X.
with the record for Coach Tom Thibodeau of the Bulls, but the rumor mill has it that the front office hasn't been happy with how hard he's ridden his top players. Lou Aldang missed time last season with the hamstring injury. Joakim Noah came down with plantar fasciitis. Hey, those things happen, and I'm not quite sure you can put that at the feet of.
Okay.
Defensively, you're going to have to tighten things up here. That's not a good sign.
Nelson kicks to Vucevic from past the arc.
That's it, baby. Nelson. What? What? That was perfect.
Jam on him.
It seems it's getting harder for players.
Okay.
I think it's going to be really interesting going forward to see this Bulls team this year and beyond. Will that wear them down? Their guys play too many minutes.
Yo, what was that?
It's time to scale back a little bit on the minutes go.
And stole.
Oh, he thought he was an all-star.
He thought he was
the best break chance. Noah with the block.
Oh, my gosh.
Weak. Alley.
Looky here, looky here.
Yo, what is going on right now?
Textbook.
Yeah, how I dribble, though? What was that?
He sure did. And how about the touch on the finish, too? That was really nicely done.
Still, it's
4-4 now.
And in the first, a over a minute and a half in. Guys are looking for a stop here.
Yeah, I mean, a cold stretch offensively. They desperately need a basket.
Nelson against Rose, fires for three.
That's it. Oh, let's go. Let's go, Nelson.
His first points of the game on the deep ball. Dishes at the Butler.
Out of there we go. There we go.
Wow.
Major unforced error right there.
He crying too.
Orlando's gone, just 1 of 4 from three-point range here in the first.
He's by himself, baby. Oh. Get the ball, man. What are you doing? There you go.
He feeds it to Davis.
There we go.
Now the dish to Vucevic.
What is he doing? Shoot the ball.
X is the
key. I did. He passed it. Like, let's
go. Did you press the...
I'll tell you what, guys. If he gets there a fraction earlier, that's a steal.
Wow. See, this is how dirty. Got the screen on.
That's no way.
Oh, boy. He is just cold.
Get the rebound, big boy. He by himself. Let's go. That's it. Count it. Let's go.
Such a clear look at that three-point shot.
Where you going, baby? Oh, he by himself.
This time the assist from Rose. Dang's good.
That hurt my feelings. He was by himself.
Dang has developed into a very good shooter, especially off spot ups or maybe one dribble pull ups. He's got range. He's developed that out to the 3-point line. But he really likes to go to that mid-range area. One or two dribbles into the paint, he'll rise up and shoot right over the top.
There you go. You know what, ball, like, you know what I'm saying?
Mo Steve, Dang is a very well-balanced player. He does a lot of good things offensively, but he's just as good at the defensive end. He's a big key to his team's tough defense.
Oladipo, he's checked in for Glenn Davis. Lock at six. And Nelson.
That layup.
Not exactly how he wanted to start this game. Just two layup, for seven, huh? But maybe that shot will get him going a little bit.
Rose kicks the butt. They get it again.
There we go. Let's go, baby.
Pushing it up. No one back to stop him. Let's it go with a three.
For three. Woo!
All these open threes they're giving up have really been the driving force of this run.
I agree, guys. And the points add up.
What? That was perfect. That was on ball, you know?
Well, he's got to watch himself now. I mean, that's two fouls already, and he can't afford another one.
Here's what Orlando's going with right now. Jason Maxeals checked in for Vucevic, and Nicholson subbed in for Harris. Butler.
Oh, got him.
And
one. Nope. Butler was the last pick of the how was that shooter foul?
2011 by the Bulls. And last season, I tell you what, he really solidified his place in the rotation, guys. He's still developing his outside shot, but he brings an awful lot to light to the table.
Aaron LaFlamme, he's checked in for Orlando. Maxeal with it. For the three. And out of bounds as Chicago gains possession.
You see in the right corner, it's how you
Chicago
right.
Trailing here.
Got him! Let's go!
That's a dunk. That's a dunk.
The three.
Let's go, baby. Let's go! Let's go! Gotta count those threes and count them up.
And for Jimmy Butler, what a story. Abandoned as a child, bounced around from home to home. One coach would take him in, another family would take him in. It was a very tough.
Let's go, baby. How? Come on. I didn't even push no buttons that time.
And to be where he is today with the great.
I didn't push any buttons that time.
Marquette, it speaks volumes of his character.
Well, it sure shows in his play, doesn't it? I mean, just the way he hustles and draws fouls, rebounds, defends. He can guard multiple positions out there. You just love his overall game and his toughness and what he brings to this team.
The shot by Harkless, no good. Bulls have gone 5 of 7 today so far. Nice shooting to get this game underway. The Bulls have converted.
Yo, the ball was free and available for me. The ball was free and available for me to pluck. I don't understand why, you know, why I'm getting these false calls on.
34-18 mark against the Eastern Conference, and it's absolutely
remarkable
considering what they had to go through personnel-wise.
And back to the Bulls in the East. It wasn't just one guy who stepped in the shoes of Rose or the departed Oshik. It was a group effort.
What was that? Why he throw the ball at his legs for?
Damn that.
Huh?
What a smooth finish.
Well, he's certainly the one they want on the end of those breaks. He always finishes.
Bruh. What is this?
We just saw courtesy of Kia. And now the first timeout called here for the Magic. To check in with Doris Burke. Doris?
Yes, over that last break.
Yeah, you look at him, know how to dribble, yo.
Hear what Jacques Vaughn said to the team. If what I heard holds true, I'd say their pick and roll is going to be their primary offensive weapon. He made sure that his guys knew that should be the play they run until the defense shows they can stop it. The next message
was
that they should be attacking the basket on offense. Felt very strongly that the defense they're up against is vulnerable.
Why is it shaking like that?
So there's plenty of time for those changes.
Why does it look like that?
Well, the Magic ended up with 20 wins on the season, which would be the worst record in the NBA last year. But
nah, no, no, let me get it. I'm just trying to, I'm trying to figure out why my eyes were twitching. I was like, yeah.
When you're a team like the Magic last season, trying to find an identity in a rebuilding year, you know, Steve, it can be hard to gel as a cohesive unit on the road.
Well, the whole year it seemed like a lot of the team was trying to figure out.
I was trying to.
Team dynamics of the talent of the new coaching staff. And it's frustrating when you're just getting beaten up every night. But you got to go through that to grow as a group. And,
Inside. Yo, how he missed it inside the paint shot?
You sure can. Not one you'd expect him to miss there.
Passes it to Butler. Out to the right wing. Heinrich from outside.
Ooh, nice.
Heinrich's got 5 points so far.
Nice pass. That one was right on target.
Here's Nelson. From deep. The scoring pass.
I'll try to pass it back out. You know what I'm saying? Gotta get little threes, man. The hustle. You don't talk?
No. I'm gonna start talking now.
Right.
I know I
can. I never said I was the best. What are you talking about?
They really clamped down hard.
They've done a nice job, Steve.
Yo, how he fall short?
Hand up on every shot.
Harkless with the
trash.
He never make it.
Like there was a little confusion there as to who was supposed to be guarding it.
Shots good.
Ooh. So why is he by himself for real?
Jimmy.
Now, here's Ola.
I would spank you in 2K15.
It's been an odd year for Kirk Heinrich, who normally is a very efficient player, but started off last season shooting way below his career norms from the floor. Ran the team pretty well, but it's kind of strange to see.
Right here, he's by himself. Yeah, he's by himself.
And out of bounds as Chicago gains possession. And the Magic making a change here. Chicago leading by 3. Outside Rose.
Yeah.
And we played through the first minute here in the second. It's rebounded by Vucevic. Vucevic has got his third rebound on the night. And going back to Heinrich, more of a jump shooter offensively. Sometimes that shot can come and, of course, as you know, go.
Nice.
Once was in his younger days, but the main attribute for Heinrich is his defense. Just an incredible defender, great footwork, fundamentals, anticipation, and much stronger than he looks. He can guard ones and twos.
Really good awareness right there on the assist.
Bulls have gone 2 of 3 from the field here to open the second quarter.
Ooh! Yeah, I can't speak for that guy. Yeah, he just got messed up.
Beyond the arc. It's hauled in by Harris. The Magic trail by 3. On the wing of Flello. There's the 3.
Come on!
Oh!
That was nice.
I don't know what happened, but I'll take the credit.
And that Clark in some muscle. Oh, he showed us he's got plenty of that with the huge dunk.
Well, in a tight game, I mean, they could use a few more of those hustle plays going forward.
Oh, that's still though. As Orlando keeps possession. He's salty as hell. He's salty as hell. He's like, it's my ball. Can I get a screen?
Here's Vucevic looking for his first basket still in this one.
Oh, come on. How you going? How you going to go in tolling one like that?
Heinrich outside. Pass to Noah. Back to Heinrich. Three-pointer.
Wow.
It was an excellent in an A-plus, too.
Here's Vucevic. And unable there.
Yo, how he missed that shot?
The last few seasons, they've done it through dominating the glass and tough defense. Had some injuries to deal with last year, but at the core, this is a defensive-minded team. That's why they're.
Oh, let's go! Let's go!
Swing it over to Doris Burke for an update. Hi, Doris.
Kevin, it certainly seemed the magic were to be lost after Dwight Howard, but they have quickly turned things around. The development of their young players last year and nabbing the number two overall pick in the draft helps team that.
Hey, J-Man, after you lose, I need a refill. I don't play these games.
They didn't get it done last season, Doris, but they're hoping with the revamped roster, this will be the year. Now Chicago's gone 0-3 from beyond the arc to start the second quarter. And the Bulls in the top five in offensive rebound rate last season.
Yeah, for a team that those extra possessions are just so valuable. And it's no surprise, really. I mean, the way this team hits the boards, Tom Thibodeau always getting peak effort out of his guys.
They swipe it.
Yo, what the?
Here comes Teague, leading the break. Tries to snap the cold streak.
Wow.
I didn't call any timeout.
A look at the hustle stats for the
ball. Or did I make a mistake in pressure?
Defense has really been impressive, putting a lot of pressure on ball handlers and turning them over.
They also came out of the locker room with their running shoes on. I mean, their transition game has been full throttle.
Let's catch up with Doris from the sideline.
Thanks, Kevin. Tom Thibodeau had some words for his team.
Give it to me, baby.
Make the extra pass. Don't try to play hero ball and do it by yourself. That ends up leading to bad shots. He went on to talk about playing a strong defensive game in the paint and denying any opportunities inside. Maybe making those early adjustments will give them time.
That's to have a smile on his face too.
By halftime, we'll soon find out, Kevin.
And as always, Doris.
I love him by myself. That's my fault.
Dunleavy's got five.
One thing you know is that the son of a coach is usually going to have good shooting mechanics, and that's definitely the case with Mike Dunleavy Jr. He always seems cool and composed when he's getting ready to fire away. He's got a great release.
What the freak? How are you, big man?
He makes the most of it.
Really was a very strong season, guys, for Jameer Nelson as he bounced back in a big way. You know, he got his scoring up.
He messed up. What is happening?
Two turnovers and no points. So far from the field here in the second quarter. Clark, you just mentioned the uptick in assists for Jameer Nelson. He's the Magic's franchise record holder in assists, Steve, with
That's a point guard.
So many back in the day, but it just shows you the consistency and the production that Nelson has given that team over almost a decade now.
That's tipped.
Oh my gosh, pick up the ball. Why is he by himself, yo?
That was way too deep.
For the ball. Out of bounds.
There you go. I'm down for that.
There's 39 seconds left in the first half.
Oh, step back.
Boozer against Max Seal. Stolen by Now here's Rose, the fast break opportunity. Very pretty.
Oh my gosh, yo.
He is a strong finisher on the fast break.
Yeah, he sure is. He remains in total control, even at full speed. I love that about him.
Oladipo misses.
He hit a three in the first, but so far has been unable to capitalize here in this quarter.
Rose goes in. And so they choose to intentionally.
Yo, what are you doing, man?
That's a strange foul.
Who knows? Maybe he just wanted to take a break for a minute.
Got it up. And that's not going to go. And the first half ends in a close one. Magic lead by one.
He's trying to get that halftime three.
Standing by on the sideline, of course.
It was a good play. He stole the ball like two times.
Now, presented by Sprint.
Welcome, fans. We've got a close game. The Sprint Halftime Report, presented by Sprint.
In real life, he's Trey.
Navy Pierre Owens.
Afalo.
Continue here in Chicago, Illinois. We've seen Aaron Afalo really having a great game.
Well, the threes have been falling for him at a ridiculous rate. First half was just amazing.
Yo, what are you doing?
He might.
Here's Vucevic, covered by Noah. Pass to Harris. A three ball. And it's... Buffalo's got the lead up to four now for the Magic. And Chicago shooting one of the high points for them in this game at 54%. Outside Butler. Rejected by Vucevic. But they recover it. Six on the shot clock. Rose passes to Boozer. Rose kicks the butt.
Oh, nice.
That's in.
This time, the assist from Rose. Rose has got four assists in the game. It's a close game here in Chicago.
You know, there was a lot of talk about the Magic not getting equal value when they traded Dwight Howard to the Lakers before last season, but you take a look at how both teams started, the Lakers and the Magic, and for a time there, the Magic had a better record early in the season than the Lakers. So,
come on, man. How are you missing stuff like that, man?
Well, Clark, like you said, hard to believe, but it's true. The Magic did have a better record than the Lakers for the early part of the season. But that was mostly due to a surprise down year from the Lakers, Steve, and a hot start for Orlando.
And remember, the Magic did get that big win at Staples against L.A. That was kind of revenge for the D. Howard trade. But as time wore on, you know, the Magic's lack of talent showed, and they really struggled the rest of the season.
Let's check out what Doris Burke has for us.
Gentlemen, in a lot of ways, Joakim Noah is the heart of this Bulls team. Coach Tom Thibodeau said, quote, "He's an all-star, and I can see him winning Defensive Player of the Year. But the most important thing is he plays to win. He can have 5 points, 10 rebounds, and 4 blocks, and he's happy because he won." Guys, Derrick Rose said it best. He's a warrior, and everybody is following him.
Thanks, Doris. He's such a character, so passionate about his defensive role. Nelson against Rose. Let's it go from the wing, and the jumper is good. Nelson's got the game tied up here for Orlando. Chicago calls timeout.
He's a point guard.
People had no idea, guys, how the Bulls were going to do last season dealing with the Rose injury, but they showed very quickly that they're going to be a team in the hunt, and they were still going to be hard to beat at home.
So Chicago ends up going with the new group. 2 minutes gone in this third quarter now. Here's Teague. That's good.
He just let him shoot. He just let him shoot, yo.
I was about to shoot him slow there.
And 17 here in this building.
Oh, yeah?
Steve, they didn't have a lot of high-flying highlights here. They knew how to close out games.
Well, they defend, and that's the main thing. If you want to finish and close out games, you have to be able to defend and rebound. And that's what Tom Thibodeau's teams are always all about. And this year is no exception.
And that one's good by Davis.
I wasn't looking. I was on the side.
Perfect on their first three shots now. That's the way to start the second half.
Let's go quickly over to Doris Burke for an update.
Thanks, Kevin. Tom Thibodeau had some
work for
his team in that last huddle. Offensively, he wants them to work the ball around more than they have been. He told his guys they've rushed things far too much at that end of the court.
Oh, no.
It's so running. Who is
it? Let's make this one a very physical.
Oh, come on, baby.
Make some changes with a good chunk of the second half still to go, Kevin.
Thank you, Doris. Here's Dunleavy.
What? No way, dude. No way.
Got 7 points in the game. Orlando, they've gone 3 of 5 to start the second half, developing a nice rhythm out there.
Yeah,
keep doing it? No, he's doing the same move over and over. And I'm playing user defense.
Heading to the hoop. Throws down.
Well, that's why they're on the lead. Aggressive play at both ends. Very nicely done there.
Yeah, absolutely. They made the steal pay dividends instantly in the open floor.
Three-pointer, Nelson. Chicago.
How did he miss that?
And now here comes Teague leading the break.
Unbelievable. Hey, get out of here.
Hey, this one counts. Clark, believe me, with confidence to attempt the alley-oop to himself.
He just couldn't resist, could he?
That was off.
A follow, no good.
You know, that mid-range jump shot is not his strong suit, even when he gets a good look like that. You know, Mike Dunleavy, the former number three overall pick back in 2002, you know, he hasn't been a star, but boy, has he been steady and productive in a very long...
That's my strategy.
Here's a follow, and lots of contact there. Missing the shot. He'll shoot.
I saw it go in. Looked like it went.
Dunleavy, very skilled at 6'9".
Yeah, he put up some pretty good numbers in Indiana.
Did it what?
Handle the ball. Son of a coach, of course, Mike Dunleavy Sr. And you can see where...
I made a free throw.
Gets his understanding of the game.
Here's what Orlando's going with right now. Maxio comes in for Vucevic, and it's Andrew Nicholson in for Glenn Davis. Heinrich dishes to Dunleavy. Shot clock at 5. Outside Butler from deep.
Oh, it's all in his face.
Hit. And Orlando the other way.
In the film session, they'll say that was a well-challenged shot.
Oh, come on, baby. There we go.
You know, we didn't see too many plays like that when they were digging this hole for themselves.
No, maybe they'll start Clark making up for it now.
It's all about effort and energy and anticipation, and they're finally getting some of that.
The shot, no good. Excellent D there from Max Eel. The Magic trail by 5. Clark, they've been struggling here on offense.
Yeah, a little bit of cotton mouth here. Dry spell for sure.
Here's Harkless.
That's all. Oh,
what the freak?
His first basket of the game. Heinrich against the follow. Upside Butler. Back to Heinrich. Fires from deep. Nicholson grabs the board. Nicholson's got 3 rebounds so far in the game.
They've been able to get out to this lead without really getting a very reliable performance out of him from the field.
Oh, that's a dunk.
To tie, Max Eel, the pass to Harkless. The feed to Max Eel.
Yo, how he missing that, yo? Come on, man.
Rebound on the night. Now Dunleavy feeds it to Gibson. Heinrich inside the 3-point. Buried it.
Boy, that was big time. Knew exact.
And a great show through 3.
Get out of here.
And, Steve, we've got a moment here to go to our State Farm assist of the game, coming on some very clever point guard play.
Well, he mans that position for a reason, Kevin, because he passes the ball so well, sets up his teammates beautifully, really gets this offense.
That's it.
Delivering the pass is important, but putting the pass in the right place for a shooter.
Come on, baby.
Outside Rose lets it go from deep.
Come on.
Rose has got the first basket as we get going in the fourth for the Bulls.
Rose.
Moving the ball now. 8 of their last 10 points coming off assisted buckets.
Steve, nothing makes a coach smile as much as pure, selfless teamwork. Early on, he tried to shoot his way out of
chair
the ball.
Chair picking.
And look for his teammates to do the scoring.
And it's going to be out of bounds.
Come on. He pushed me out of bounds. I was about to go baseline. Don't
not if that's going to be the result.
Davis has checked in for Orlando. Nelson.
His face just went in my face.
Nelson with another miss.
Get off the three. You got
score like it is. They did
can't afford to get lazy with.
You know, I think the effort's been there, Steve, but they're still getting outworked just by a skosh.
Here's Dang. The Bulls keep it alive. And Gibson kicks to Rose. And the Bulls.
Ooh.
Terrific job of getting offensive rebounds and then converting those here in the second half. It is one thing to get the offensive rebound. They've turned them all.
Time call here.
Bruh.
Just too many easy buckets, you know, in and around the paint. So he wants to put a stop to it. His timeout is going to be used to try to tighten up the defense.
Guys, at this level, they won't miss often. If looks inside.
Don't bring in that hot trash. I am.
For the Magic, Harkless has jumped in for Vucevic.
Oh, I'm already beaten by 10. I actually won this game.
And it's a follow from Harris. Doris Burke has some information for us. Doris?
I want this video. What Jock
Vaughn was going over with his team. He warned his team to get back in transition defense, saying
stop shooting threes. Too many fast
break buckets, and he wants an end to it. He said, hey, let's slow the tempo and make him take some tough shots.
Well, I don't know how to drive it to the goal. So.
And Dang, here we go. Wants to get it to Rose, and does. And the call will be against Jameer Nelson. That will get him his fourth foul.
All you have to do, hold this button, go to the basket.
And now he's got some foul trouble hanging over his head, guys.
Boozer, he's checked in for Chicago. And the foul on Victor Oladipo. That'll be his second foul of the game.
I make contact with the ball. I don't know what they were blowing whistle.
It's stolen by Oladipo.
Well, he's been pretty safe with the ball for the most part. In fact, that's his first turnover, guys.
Got that bucket in no time at all.
You live by the three.
14 points for Jameer Nelson.
And this is someone that can really hurt you from long range. He did that to a degree in the first half, and he's doing it now.
And again, no good by Chicago.
Well, I think he kind of alligator armed that one. Short stroke. After doing a nice job to get open, he didn't finish the shot.
Chicago leading by 7. Rose with the ball. And it's Nelson picking him up from the baseline. Rose, that's good.
He's got so much junk in his trunk. He'll find a way to hurt you.
And now a look to the stands as he tells those fans, let's go.
And they're always listening, Kevin.
They are.
If he's the one doing the talking anyway. Right.
Kind of like when you're doing the talking with us. We're always listening.
Always.
Always.
That's right.
And this will give him.
He's about to throw that down.
Give me a major lift when I hear you talking the way you're talking around the game. Multiple possessions have been the story of the game, and even with the big lead, this team continues to be quicker to the ball.
Here's Oladipo, nailed from
there. We go.
D there, guys, was pretty much.
I can't wait. He was by himself.
Let's find out what Doris Burke has for us.
Yes. Over the break, I just put in on Jock Vaughn's huddle. He started like discussing how they wanted to defend against Rose. With him going on this tear, Coach said it's got to be a team effort. He wants everyone dialed in and paying attention to the details. He's trying to get them all on the same page and figure out an answer. Guys, we'll see how Coach's direction pays off as this one winds down. Kevin?
Great. Thanks for the report, Doris. And the rejection.
What the freak? Shut up.
Nelson kicks to Davis. And airballs the triple. That one was way off. Vucevic, and he drops in the layup off the glass.
Use your size, boy. Use your size.
So he knows that those are the easiest points for him, when he can find a loose ball, get an offensive board, and put it back into the basket.
And he is also a tireless worker under the glass, Steve. More than a few guys have been on the receiving end of one of his elbows when the rebound is up for grabs. He uses his body very well.
Doesn't go either for Davis.
Well, they're trying to come back here, but you got to get a better look at the basket to get it done.
And some stats here, guys.
Nah, this is sucking. Can I just trade him out?
Great ball move.
They've been firing on all cylinders in the transition game, too. I mean, they've really run the break.
By luck. His dude tracks like three.
He's got 8 points now and three great steals.
Oh, that was lucky. That was lucky.
With his passing and with his defensive work.
Well, he's been so active on the court at both ends. And
it's not even that late in the game.
Kirk Heinrich, he's checked in for Rhodes.
Why'd you try to touch? You stupid.
Harris outside. Left side, Davis. A follow outside. Another miss.
Late release. Oh,
Chicago leading. Fires the three. And Heinrich at the basket.
Oh, nice three.
Butler's got four assists now tonight.
You know, sometimes you don't like to see guys pull up from three-point range on the break. But for him, with nobody on him, that's a pretty good shot.
Doris Burke has an update for us. Doris?
Yes, over the break, I listened in on Jacques Vaughn's huddle. He told his players not to spend so much time trying to find the perfect shot. He said, listen, there are no bad shots. Take them when you've got them. And before the huddle broke up, he mentioned playing active defense in transition.
Nice. Oh, that's a three. I was behind. I was in front of the line.
Changes hands. Guys, they're operating under the principle that it's never too late to fine-tune the game plan. Kevin, over to you.
And thanks for that story, Doris. Nelson from outside, and the shot is good. Nelson's got six in the quarter.
He's putting on a commanding performance here. He's hit 2 3-pointers in each half now.
Heinrich kicks the butt. Back to Heinrich. Jacks up a three. Poked loose. Butler against Nelson. Nails it!
Ooh. No one just slapped him.
Boy, he quieted the crowd with that big shot. That's a big play.
Yeah, the crowd's been hoping for something
good
to
stuff,
do.
Oh, my. That's. That's.
Oh, wow. Dude was all in his face right there.
Look at him.
40 seconds left in the fourth.
It's going to take something special, maybe a miracle, for them to come back right now.
How about a little luck?
Nelson. Here's Vucevic. The pass to Harris. And foul called.
Oh, he laid again. That should have been a clear pass. Yes. Clear pass foul. I get
these first. That makes it a 7-point lead. Second one is good. Getting both at the line. It's an 8-point game.
Ooh, why is he fouling? What's he doing?
It's a late game.
Pretty much over.
Yeah, they're just extending this. We need running time in effect here, Steve.
So a new group on the floor for Orlando. And both free throws good from Heinrich.
And that's exactly how you close the game out. Those free throws will vary.
That's how you close the game out with fouls.
Out the window. I think this lead is safe now.
Yep, this one's a done deal.
Who's with it? Moore with the steal. Pass to Oladipo. Shot to stop the run. Here's Harkless. Noah with the block. And out of bounds is Chicago.
What? Wow.
Here's Heinrich. Off target.
GG, GG, good game.
Good game.
Well, guys, this has been your boy, Tice SODMG, and I just lost to J, man. Peace!
Money. Gotta get the money. Money. Gotta get the money. Money back.